Once you have imported a database project into FmPro Migrator Platinum Edition, a live code stack file will be generated by FmPro Migrator. Each layout, form, report, and its included objects will be converted into a card within this new stack file. First, you would have made sure that there was a primary key for each database table. Then you would have imported the FileMaker Pro, Microsoft Access, or Visual FoxPro project into FmPro Migrator. The step number 4 transfer data step should have been completed for all database tables. I'm using SQLite during this video, having placed the SQLite file into the project directory. Live code, either community or commercial edition, should be installed. SQL Yoga from Blue Mango Learning should have been downloaded. Click on the Live Code Conversion button on the GUI tab of the Migration Process window. Note, at this point in the conversion, the process remains the same whether you are using Mac or Windows. On the Live Code Conversion window, there are several options which can be selected. The version of the Live Code stack file you want to create. Version 8 is the default. Card script status is either normal or commented. Select commented if you want to skip reading data from the database when cards are open, just so that you can review the objects on the cards. Selecting the licensed menu and clicking the clipboard icon pastes the license key from the clipboard. You can skip this step if you're using the demo version. On the live code conversion window, we can see that there are 9 layouts or forms, which will be converted into the new live code stack. Click the Migrate button to start the conversion, and within seconds, the conversion has been completed. During this time, the new live code stack has been created, a card has been created for each layout or form, and SQL Yoga has been added to the stack. I have opened the Live Code 8 version of the stack, created by FmPro Migrator. I click the Create SQL Yoga Objects button. Then, I click the Connect button. The database connection is made to the SQLite database. Of course, any supported database could be used. Once the database connection has been made, the first record of the first card is displayed. I will resize the stack to display more info. Notice that there is data within the fields, including the image field. If I click on the field, I get a pop-up menu allowing me to select an image to be inserted into the database. This is how the images were inserted into the SQLite database. Notice that the data grid is showing the records in the related table. Scrolling down further, I see a tab control which has been converted into a Live Code 8 segmented widget. Clicking the segments displays the objects within the group for each segment. Clicking the Layouts menu, I can select the Members card and advance between the records. I can also select the Pie Chart Gallery and Bar Chart Gallery cards and see the Line Graph widgets on these cards. I have already opened the Live Code 7 version of the same stack file. This stack was created by selecting Live Code 7 from the Version menu in FmPro Migrator. You will notice that objects like push buttons and tab controls look a little different compared to the Live Code 8 version. Scrolling to the right, you can see that the buttons are the classic versions. You can see the related records in the data grid. And notice that the tab control is a regular tab control with objects contained within a group for each tab. The automated building of the new live code stack file is a great start to the conversion process. The remaining steps need to be completed manually. These tasks include fixing cosmetic issues on cards in the stack, reviewing the contents of the FmPro converted script.txt file, then adding and modifying this code as needed to the appropriate objects within the stack.